Hey yo, what's good you hypies? Welcome back to the channel. If you guys are new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And also, don't forget to turn your post notifications so you guys don't miss out on any future videos just like this one. So today I'm going to be getting into if you guys should buy a Mophie charger from Supreme. So basically, if you guys should pay resale for them. I have the two Supreme chargers right in front of me. I have the stats right in front of me. And then I have the ones from Mophie, the regular ones that aren't Supreme, on my phone right here. And I'm going to be comparing both of them for you guys because I know these can come in really handy, especially when your battery's dying and you're nowhere near an outlet and you need a charger on the spot. And I know you guys might think like, oh, why would I be carrying this around at all times? I mean, if you have a bag like me, I have my Gucci bag that I wear all the time. I wear it everywhere. I always have my big Supreme charger in there and I carry it everywhere just in case I need to charge my phone and I don't have an outlet or I'm too lazy to be next to an outlet and I can just carry it and have it next to me. Whatever the circumstance may be, you are going to need a charger at one point. It happens to everybody. All right, so we're going to start off with the 10K battery. This is a Supreme one. Right here, it does say Supreme. It doesn't even say Supreme all the way. It stops at the E like halfway through it. And then we do have the stats of this one right here, which is the one that's from Mophie, which is going to be cheaper. The price of the regular Mophie one is $69.95, which I'm pretty sure you gotta pay taxes on. And on top of that, you might have to pay shipping if you buy it online. However, if you buy it in store, you can obviously get it for $69.95. This one right here actually costs $88 plus the $10 shipping, which was the retail price. However, now on StockX and other people, you can probably get it for a lower price because people aren't really paying resale for these too much. So you can probably get them for the same as retail price, or if not, a little bit lower. And because they're 10K, they both should be similar, right? And they pretty much are. However, here's the differences. This is supposed to charge a smartphone for 59 hours, while the one on their website is supposed to charge for 48 hours. So you are getting 11 more hours out of this one compared to this one for $18 on your smartphone, which is what most likely you're gonna use it for. For a large smartphone on the website, it says it's going for 38 hours. So it can only charge pretty much my phone, which is a large smartphone, for 38 hours. And let's say for this one, if we take out 10 hours of it, you're still gonna get 49 hours out of this one, which is still more than this one on a small smartphone, which is 48 hours. So for 18 bucks more, you're getting 10 to 11 hours more of charging on this one than you do on this one. And plus, you get some clout points, you look like a hypies with it. Looks pretty dope. As far as a small tablet on this one goes, it can charge up to 24 hours. As far as a small tablet on this one goes, it goes to 14 hours. So once again, for 10 hours more of charging, which is gonna be like two more charges, you do get more out of this one for only 18 bucks more. And you're not only paying for the name, but you're actually even paying for the service that they're providing with this, which is obviously more charge time. So out of these two, I would have to say go with the Supreme one. So moving on to the 20K one, this one is called the Mophie Encore 20K, while the one on the website is called the PowerStation XXL. And it is made for smartphone, tablets, and USB devices, which serves the same exact purpose as this one. The price of the PowerStation XXL is $99.95, and then on top of that, you might have to pay tax, and on top of that, you might have to pay shipping. I don't know what their shipping discounts are on the website. However, we're strictly just gonna go based off retail price. The retail price of this one was actually $98, which is actually cheaper than the PowerStation. And already the price of this one already beats it. However, you do have to pay $10 shipping, which does go to 108, and it's honestly $8 more than the regular one on the Mophie website. So for the price, you're already winning on this one. So for a regular smartphone, the PowerStation is supposed to charge your phone for up to 100 hours, while this one is supposed to charge it up to 105 hours. It doesn't specify if it's a small or large iPhone for this one, but let me compare that to the large smartphone on this one, which it does say it will charge it to 75 hours, while this one, it still says 105, but even if we take 25 off of that, you're still getting 80 hour charge time, which is still 5 hours more than the regular PowerStation. As far as a small tablet goes, the Supreme one is supposed to charge it for 37 hours, while the PowerStation is only charging it for 28 hours. And the large tablet on this one is 23 hours, which is only 5 hours less than the small tablet. So you can already imagine this one on a large tablet probably won't even go past 20 hours. So you guys heard of the details. You guys already can tell which one's gonna be the better one. Obviously, this is a Supreme, and this one fully says Supreme all the way through it. If you're spending 10 more dollars than the regular small one that I have right here, you're getting a way better deal with this one because you're getting way more charge time for only 10 bucks more. And I already made a comparison between these two. This one is almost double the size of this one as far as battery life goes. It is 20K, 10K, come on, like do the math, it's pretty simple. So now it comes down to these two. If I were to recommend which one to buy, I would say buy this one. The only reason you would buy this one is because it is half the size, which means it is half the weight. It is easier to carry and it is lighter. So it's up to you guys if you guys wanna spend $10 more just to get this one compared to this one. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to smash that thumbs up button. And also don't forget to give me a thumbs up because we are on the road to 32,000 subscribers by the end of this month. And also once you click that subscribe button, you do get the option to opt into my notifications, which you might as well so you guys don't miss out on any future videos just like this one. Anyways, today's fan of the day is go to Efren Fuentes. If you want to be fan of the day, all you gotta do is subscribe to this channel and leave a positive comment down below. Anyways, guys, until next time, make sure you guys keep grinding. It's your boy, Sneaker, signing out.